Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny. We're here alongside the Trinity River. We're on the Trinity-Humboldt County line in northwestern California to bring you a specially researched recipe.
Today we're making a thick, meaty beef stew. Stay tuned. All right, the first order of business is I need to make some paste. And I'll be using 4 fillets of anchovies. And a shout out to one of our most prolific posters, John. Look what my most amazing wife found. Yep, black garlic to go along with the white garlic. We'll be using some tomato paste and a little bit of Lee and Perrins. Okay, now we're going to mix this together and we're going to form a paste. Now we're going to set this aside and we're going to start prepping the meat. Here's a magic trick for you. Pulled apart at the seams and trimmed. And cut into 2 separate batches for browning. I'm getting ready to sear and brown the meat. I'm going to do it in 2 batches. But right now I'm heating up my pot. And then I'll put in the oil and heat that up. I've added the oil. It's starting to smoke. So I can sear the unseasoned meat. Okay, this is the second batch of meat. We'll get this one browned up and then we'll put the first batch back in with this batch and we'll go from there. Both batches of meat are in the oven. Now I can add the onions and the carrots. Okay, I'm scraping the bottom when I stir this. I want to pick up any brown bits from when I was browning the meat. All that stuff adds flavor. And now that the onions are soft, looks like I can add the garlic mixture. That awesome paste from earlier. Well, you can really smell this. And this is going to add more good stuff to scrape off the bottom. Now I can add the wine. we'll be putting in 2 cups. Gonna stir this around a bit before I add the 2nd cup. Got just a little bit ahead of myself. But I haven't added all the wine yet. We gotta stir this around until all the dry flour is absorbed. Now I'm going to add the 2nd cup of wine. This wine is reducing wonderfully. So now I can crank the heat up. I can add the broth and the salt pork. Adding in the salt pork. This will come back out when we're done before we serve it. Putting in a few small bay leaves. Now I couldn't find fresh thyme, so I got some dried stuff. I'm not going to be able to take this back out. That's going to stay in. The fresh thyme, they say to remove it before you serve it. Okay, now I can reduce this down to a simmer. And I'm going to add the potatoes. Okay, now I can cover this up and we can simmer it for 1.5 hours. Let's see how the simmer is. That's nice. We need to let this simmer for 1.5 hours. With this wind, I don't feel comfortable using briquettes with no established fire ring or my cooking table with me. So I'm going to babysit this to guard against blowouts for 1.5 hours. So we'll see you in a little while. It's been simmering for 1.5 hours. Now I'm going to add the gelatin as a thickener instead of more flour. And I can start to take out the salt pork And I can start looking for bay leaves to take those out. There's one. So now we can crank this up a little bit hotter to really activate that gelatin. Now I can add a cup and a half of pearl onions. And those are frozen, by the way. And we'll follow that up with the frozen peas shortly. Aha, there you are. Now we put the cup of frozen peas in. And the only thing left to do is when we serve it up is let the person season to taste with salt and pepper. I'm going to put a little parsley on it. Put some of my favorite coarse black pepper. Woo! And put a little bit of salt. Yes, can't wait to try this.
Stew for me, stew for you.
Oh, wow. This is delicious. packed full of flavor. For those of you who are squirmish about the idea of putting anchovies in with this, there's no fish taste, just ultimate flavors. We hope you enjoyed today's webisode.
We'd like to take this opportunity to thank our friends who are allowing us this opportunity to film on this beautiful piece of property, and our love to Diana.
Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
And until the next time, happy trails to you.